Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Welcome to us all to this episode, episode 26 of the Golden Way series. Inshallah, in this episode, we will complete the Al-Ghad, the article Al-Ghad, so that we are hopeful that at least we've been able to complete one article from the book Al-Nazarat by Ustaz Mustafa Al-Manfuluti, Sheikh Mustafa Lutfi Al-Manfuluti. So at least when you pick the book, you know that you've done one article from the book. Inshallah, we are going to be quick on this. It's not that much left for us, about two paragraphs or so. Okay, so he says, Ayyuha Shabahu, he is then describing tomorrow as being the future, as being the hidden future, the secret that only God knows, and as being whatever it is, as being the Shabah, which is the ghost-like being that can't be reached, and all that. After all this, then now he's coming to speak to tomorrow. Before, he was talking to us about Al-Ghadu Shabahun, Al-Ghadu, then he will say Al-Ghadu Bahrun Khidam, then he will come to Al-Ghadru Sadrun Mamnu, Ka'anni Bil-Ghad. He's finished all this talk about tomorrow. That is, he was explaining what tomorrow and our future is. But now, what he's coming to do is, he's coming to speak to tomorrow direct. The future, he's coming to talk to the future one-on-one. And then what did he say? He says, Ayyuha Shabahu, Ayyuha Shabahu Al-Mulathamu Bilitham Al-Ghaybi. Ayyuha, calling somebody. And the Ayyuha, usage of Ayyuha, you know when you're calling somebody, you have Ya, you have Ah, Hamza, you have a lot of them like that. But usage of Ya, usage of Ayyuha shows a bit of distance. Sometimes you see Ya Ayyuha, it also shows farther, more farther distance. So here it says, Ayyuha Shabahu Al-Mulathamu Bilithami Al-Ghayb. Al-Shabahu, we've already said, Al-Ghadu Shabahun Mubham. Shabah, as we said, is the ghost-like thing that you can't, kind of a spirit, you can't really find a body for it, but it looks like it has a being. Okay. And then, Al-Mulathamu. Al-Mulatham is somebody who has covered his face with a veil. And the veil is what is mentioned here, Litham. So he says, Al-Mulathamu, oh you ghost, ghost-like being, Mulathamu, who has covered his face, Bilitham Al-Ghayb, with the veil of the unseen, Al-Ghayb. Bilitham, Litham is, some of these Arabs, I think it's in movies, you hardly see somebody, like they drop the whole veil on their face. It happens, I think it happens. That is what we call litham. So he says, Ayyuha Shabahu Al-Mulathamu Bilitham Al-Ghayb. Oh you ghost-like being that have covered your face, who is covered with the litham al-ghayb, that is the veil of the unseen. So tomorrow is being covered by the concept of being unseen. Hal laka, he says, hal laka an tarfa. Hal laka is like, would you, kind of seeking you to do something for me. So if I say, hal laka an tusa'idani, can you help me? Okay. Says, هل لك أن ترفع عن وجهك هذا اللثام قليلا? Would you kindly raise from your face, ترفع عن وجهك, raise from your face, هذا اللثام, this veil, قليلا, a bit. He's asking tomorrow to raise the veil of the unseen a bit. لنرى صفحة واحدة. He says, لنرى صفحة واحدة من صفحات وجهك المقنع. لنرى, so that we see, صفحة. And when we say صفحة, صفحة, everybody knows صفحة to be a page. Okay, how did he even come to reach a page? When we say صفحة, we mean a side of something. صفحة الوجه means a side of the face. صفحة الشيء, يعني جانبه. So if he says صفحة, that's why we call this a page, that is a page. Because it is a side of it, and this is also a side of it. Okay, so he says, he's asking tomorrow to raise the veil of the unseen a bit, so that we see a side, one side, صفحةً واحدةً. So that we see one side, من صفحات وجهك المقنع, among one side, among the size of your covered face. And when we say muqanna, it also means covered. You know, this mask, the nose masks, they are called, some call them muqannaat or something. So if somebody does this, this is muqanna. So I'm like, I like this, ana muqanna'un. I've covered my face. If I do that, I've covered my face. So he says, he's asking tomorrow to kindly raise the veil of the unseen a bit so that we see a side among the size of his face that has been covered. Al-muqanna'un. Al-muqanna'un, that has been covered. He says, awla, or not. Or like you speak to somebody and you are like, can we go out today? Then you sense some kind of danger, then you're like, oh no, or not, you just leave it, kind of that kind of language. So when he asks tomorrow to raise off the veil a bit, then he says, awla, or not, or you just don't do it. Faqtarib minna qalilan, or awla, if you won't do it, faqtarib minna qalilan, iqtarib, come close, qalilan, a bit. اقترب منا قليلا, come close to us, draw nigh a bit. علنا, علا is لعلنا, perhaps, says علنا نستشف صورتك من وراء هذا اللثام المزبل دوننا. He says علنا, perhaps we نستشف. And when we say استشافة, بمعنى to see something behind a veil. Like you see sometimes there is a veil and you can see something behind it. You can see the body of it. You can see something. At least it gives you a gesture of what is behind the veil. That is what he's requesting for now. If you think you can't raise for us to see your face, you draw nigh. اقترب منا قليلا. علنا, perhaps we, نستشف, we would see behind the veil, صورتك, your image, من وراء هذا اللسام, behind this veil, you are covering your face with. And he says, bihazal min wara'i hadha al-lisan, behind this veil, al-musbil. And when we say al-musbil, is bal, to drag something. And when we say something is musbil, that is the thing has been dropped, like a curtain. When you drop the curtain like that, that is what we call is bal. And he says, al-musbil dunana, this veil that has been dropped to block us. And then he says, فَقَدْ طَارَتْ قُلُوبُنَا, our hearts have flown or have flew, شَوْقًا إِلَيْكَ, due to longingness towards you. Our hearts have flew due to longingness towards you, wishing for our future. So our hearts has flew towards you. And he says, وَذَابَتْ أَكْبَادُنَا, أَكْبَاد is the plural of kebd, and that is the liver, or it is sometimes used for the heart. Take that. وَذَابَتْ, to melt. وَذَابَتْ أَكْبَادُنَا وَجْدًا عَلَيْكَ, and our hearts or our livers have melted. وَجْدًا, وَجْد is also a form of حُب, عِشْق, شَوْق. They are all form of love, emotions. It says, وَذَابَتْ أَكْبَادُنَا وَجْدًا عَلَيْكَ, and our livers or our hearts have also melted due to longingness for you. That is, in weight of our future, our hearts have flown into the future, and our livers have also melted, or our hearts have melted towards you, or alayka, due to desire towards you. And he says, ayuha al-ghadu, he's calling on to tomorrow again, or the future. Ayuha al-ghadu, inna lana amalan kibaran, amal, as we've already seen, hopes. Inna lana amalan kibaran, indeed we have big hopes, wasigaran, and small hopes. Wa amani umniya is wishes. Wa amani hisanan, and we have good wishes. Wa ghayra hisanin, and also those that are not good. That is, we have good wishes and bad wishes. Fahadithna, so tell us an amalina, about our hopes. Aina makanuha minka, what is his position with you, our hopes? If he says, aina makanu ha minka, if I ask you, aina makanu ridwan minka, I'm not asking you where is Ridwan's position like this with you. I'm asking you, how do you regard Ridwan? If I say, aina makanu ridwan minka, aina makanu abika minka, where is your father's position with you? That means, how do you regard your father? That is the language you should take from here. if somebody should ask you that, you can use it too. It's a skillful language. And he says, فَحَدِّثْنَا عَنْ أَعْمَالِنَا أَيْنَ مَكَانُهَا مِنْكَ. Tell us about our hopes. How do you regard them? Or how are they with you? وَخَبِّرْنَا عَنْ أَمَانِينَا. خَبِّرْنَا بِمَانَا حَدِّثْنَا. And also inform us, عَنْ أَمَانِينَا, about our wishes. مَاذَا صَنَعْتَ بِهَا. What have you done with our wishes? Because you are the future, you know it. So he's speaking to the future. What have you done with our wishes? And he says, أَأَذْلَلْتَهَا وَاحْتَقَرْتَهَا. Sorry. He says, أَأَذْلَلْتَهَا وَاحْتَقَرْتَهَا. أَذَلَّ, أَذْلَلْتَ is from أَذَلَّ. أَذَلَّ, to demean something. When somebody has عِزَّة, ذَلِيل is the opposite of عَزِيز. Something is dear, it is aziz. When something is unworthy, not worthy, you don't really desire it, that is what we call dhalil. We have human beings, we have those who are aziz or aiza, and then this we have dhalil, those who are base, they have low. So he's asking, adhlaltaha, these are our wishes, have you debased them or rubbish them? Have you made nothing of them? وَاحْتَقَرْتَهَا. And also, اِحْتَقَرَ, that is to disrespect something. That's what they say. What do they even say in Amiya? They said, اِوْعَ أَنْ تَحْتَكِرَ أَحْدًا. Be careful not to demean somebody, disrespect somebody. So he's asking tomorrow, have you demeaned our wishes? Have you made rubbish of them? Or have you disrespected them, or kind of ihtakara, to find something unworthy? And he says, am kunta laha min al-mukramin. Am kunta laha min al-mukramin, bimana am akramtaha. Or have you honored our wishes and our hopes? Am kunta laha min al-mukramin. Or you have been among those, the honorable ones, to our wishes, or towards our wishes. And then he says, la. No, he's asking tomorrow to tell us something and all that, requesting a lot of things from tomorrow. And now what does he do? He says, la, no, don't. Sun sirraka fi sadrika. Sun, protect, from suana yasunu. Sun, protect. Says, sun sirraka fi sadrika. Keep your secrets in your chest. This is tomorrow. The ka here is about tomorrow. Ayu al-ghad. Sun sirraka fi sadrika. Keep your secret in your chest. And he says, wabqi lithamaka, wabqi lithamaka ala wajhika. And keep your veil on your face. He no more wants you to unveil. Keep your veil on your face. Wala tuhadithna hadithan. And also do not tell us anything at all. La tuhadithna hadithan. Do not tell us anything. ولا تحدثنا حديثا واحدا. And do not tell us anything عن أمالنا وأمانينا. And do not tell us anything about our hopes and wishes. Before he was requesting for this, and now it's like he came to the realization, oh no, you don't, leave it. And then he says, حتى لا تفجعنا في أرواحنا, so that you do not put fear in us. أفجع, oh, حتى لا تفجعنا, so that you do not scare us, put fear in us. From afja, yufjiu, to put fear in us. And he says, aw hatta la tafja'na. It is also read that way, faja'a, from fear. Hatta la tafja'na fi arwahina, so that you do not put fear in our souls, wa nufusana, and ourselves. Fa innama nahnu, for indeed we, أحياءٌ, we are alive بالأعمال, due to our hopes. It is a kind of wise saying that is used a lot. إنما نحن أحياء بالأعمال. So if you don't have hopes, you are considered ميت. من ليس لديه أعمال فهو ميت. أو من ليس لديه أعمال فهو ميت. The one who does not have hopes is dead. So they say, إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ أَحْيَاءَ, أي بِسَبَبِ الْأَعْمَالِ, we are alive due to our hopes. وإن كانت باطلة, even if these hopes are falsehood, they are not, they are in vain. وسعداء, and we are happy بالأماني due to our wishes. Okay, I have this kind of wishes, so it keeps me. These wishes keeps me. And he says, وإن كانت كاذبة, even if these wishes are lies, even if they are falsehood, they keep us going. You have the hope, and you have some wishes, and you have hopes that next you become this and you become that. It keeps you going. If not, a lot of us would have just quenched and then just dropped up, dropped down everything. And lastly, he says, وليست حياة المرء إلا أمانية. وليست حياة المرء إلا أمانية. And a person's life is nothing but wishes. إذا هي ضاعت فالحياة على الأثر. If these wishes are to go lost, then life also follows in suit. He says again, وليست حياة المرء إلا أمانية. A person's life is nothing but hopes and wishes. إذا هي ضاعت, if these wishes and hopes should die out, if you do not have them anymore, you do not have hopes and wishes anymore, فالحياة, then life itself, على الأثر, will also follow suit. Life will also die out like the way wishes have died out. Okay, this brings us to the end of the text. As you can see, we've ended it. The next topic in the book is Al-Kasul Al-Ula, but we are not taking that in this Golden Word series. Inshallah, if you would have lessons for Al-Manfluti separately, we will take care of that. Okay, so this brings us to the end of this episode, episode 28. I hope it's been educational since the beginning. I've always been saying, it's all about the knowledge. We are just trying our best to give out what we know, what the little we know in this language, so that colleagues will also benefit from this. Those who seek to learn will also find certain things that are easy to that will easily aid them into their path. Or as we've learned, you have wenu lahum al-tariq, it makes the path easy for them, inshallah. So we will meet again. Ramadan Mubarak. Have a blessed Ramadan. And Eid is just around the corner, inshallah. May we all witness the Eid together, happily, in also good mood. Okay, may Allah bless the Ummah for us. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.